What's up, guys? Welcome to part 2 of how to draw a flat sketch or a technical sketch. In part 1, we learned how to create this template, which is basically the secret to drawing any flat sketch. It takes just 10 minutes to create, but you can literally use it the rest of your fashion design career to create any garment from scratch. So if you missed how I created this, I recommend that you head over to part 1 and watch that, because in this video, we are continuing to use that template to draw a basic jacket, a basic pair of jeans, a basic jogger, and a basic cardigan. So let's jump right in. So we have 3 garments drawn out and complete from part 1, and we're now heading to garment number 4, which is a basic pair of jeans. So continuing on our A3 size Adobe Illustrator artboard, I'm zooming in to the body form that we drew and starting at the waist with my pen tool. Draw the waistband, followed by the left half of the body. Then copy and paste it like I have taught you in part 1 using the shortcuts Command C and Command Shift V in order to place a copy exactly over the original. Then right click the copy and go to Transform and Reflect. Make sure vertical is selected and hit OK. Then move the copy to the right side. Now let's group it all together by highlighting them and hitting Command G on your keyboard. Let's then take our pair of jeans to the artboard on the right so that we can work on it even more closely. The first step, like always, is to simply hit D on your keyboard. This keyboard shortcut will automatically give the shapes that form your jeans a white fill and a black outline. I'm then using my pen tool to draw the inner backs of the legs. And at the waistband, let's draw in a vertical line at the center front and also draw in the inner back here as well. Let's next move to creating our stitch lines. So the first stitch line I am creating is for my waistband. Exactly like we did in part 1, I'm right-clicking on the waistband and selecting Isolate Selected Path. This will allow me to isolate and work on the waistband alone. All the other shapes behind will remain untouched while I work my mouse around. Now on my waistband, I need stitch lines running right next to the upper border and the lower border. For this, instead of drawing a new line from scratch, I'm taking my direct selection tool and highlighting the line forming the top of the waistband only. Then copy and paste the line using Command C and Command Shift V. A copy of just that line has now been pasted exactly over the original, and I'm now using my downward arrow key to move the copy downwards. Once it has reached where I want my stitch line to fall, I'm selecting my eyedropper tool and simply clicking an existing stitch line from the shirt I previously made above. The eyedropper tool basically converts a highlighted line into anything it touches. I'm following the exact same steps for a stitch line at the bottom of my waistband. I'm then double-clicking the background so that I can come out of the isolated waistband shape because I am done working on it. Next, I'm drawing a stitch line running from the crotch to the waistband and also drawing the fly. While we are here, working on the upper half of the jeans, let's also draw in the pockets. Create a curved line like so and copy-paste it to create a double needle stitch line below. Reflect it onto the other side. For the inner back of the waistband as well, draw a stitch line. Now let's move to the coin pocket on the left and draw it out. Once that is done, let's create a stitch line that runs vertically along the side seams of the jeans. For this, with my direct selection tool, I'm highlighting the line that forms the side seam with the anchor points on it, then copy-pasting it, move it a bit to the left, and using my eyedropper tool to make a stitch line. Reflect onto the left side, and also create the same at the inseam of the jeans. Next, I'm going to finish off with my stitch lines by going to the hem and drawing in a double needle stitch like so. And for the inner back hem, we're drawing an undashed line followed by a stitch line below because this represents the hem that is folded in and stitched. As these are jeans, we will need to add belt loops as they are a key detail. For this, I'm starting by drawing a curved shape like this with my pen tool, then creating stitch lines, and also drawing in the fold of fabric that will fall behind. And since belt loops look like this with bar tags at the top and the bottom, I'm gonna add the zigzag line that we created in part one to the top and bottom like so. Then reduce the size and add it to the waistband at the front and at the back. I'm then creating the black border using the techniques I showed you in part one. After that, I'm copying and pasting the buttonhole that we made for the shirt in part one and pasting it here for the center front button on the jeans. Except let's place it horizontally. And for the button, I'm drawing a circle with my ellipse tool first. Remember to hold down shift while drawing so that you get a perfectly round circle. Then come to your gradient panel on the right and click on radial gradient. This will give your button that metallic sort of look. Now copy paste and reduce the size to make smaller circles that act as the metal rivets that are placed at pocket ends. In case you're wondering, the rivets are actually placed here for additional reinforcement. As a final step, I'm drawing in the lines and the folds of my jeans with my pen tool and changing the variable width profile to width profile 1 to give it a more realistic look. Garment number 4 is now ready. Let's move to garment number 5, which is a basic pair of joggers. I'm starting on my body form again by drawing the right half of my waistband only, giving it this curvy scalloped side. Then draw the body and the cuff. Copy, paste, reflect. Group everything and bring it to the artboard on the right. I'm gonna start by joining the left and the right halves of my waistband into one and then hitting D. Now let's draw the inner backs of the jogger. I'm moving to the pockets and then beginning with my stitch lines and pleat detailing at the waistband. Now the waistband has two rows of stitch lines like this because it is an elasticated waistband. I'm drawing the stitch lines at the crotch and a mock fly in this case. Then as my waistband is elasticated, I need to show folds in the fabric that look like this. For this, I'm going to create a pattern brush in the same way that we created zigzag lines and the zipper teeth in part one. I'm starting by drawing a bunch of lines, curvy and straight in this manner with my pen tool. Align them all by coming up here and hitting vertical align top. Then group them all together by hitting Command G. I'm also changing the variable width profile to width profile 1 so that the lines change to being tapered at the ends and thicker at the center. Next, draw a rectangle around it like so, removing the stroke and fill. Then right-click the rectangle and send it to the back by going to Arrange and Send to Back. Next, highlight both the lines inside and the rectangle outside. Go to Brush Definition, click on New Brush, Pattern Brush, and hit OK. Your pattern brush with the fabric folds has now been created. Let's hit OK and test it out. Draw a straight line and then select the brush that you just created. And this looks awesome, so let's go add it to the waistband. I'm going to copy and paste one of my stitch lines, moving it above and unticking dashed line. Then select the brush you just made, reduce the size to 0.003 inches and create a copy for the lower two sections of the waistband as well. Repeat the same for the cuff at the hem. I'm then going to create the black outlines of my jogger. Also color all the inner backs gray. Next, for the waistband, I'm also going to create eyelets as well as a draw cord running through them. I'm clicking on my ellipse tool and drawing a circle. Increase the stroke width a bit, expand the shape, and hit D to give it a white fill and a black outline. Then create a copy to its right. Then with the pen tool, draw a curved line joining one hole to the other. While the line is highlighted, come to your stroke panel on the right and choose round cap so that the ends of the line will be curved. Next, increase the stroke width so that it starts to look like a draw chord. After this, I'm going to draw the draw chord forming a bow. See this edge peeking out? We can blunt it by going to the stroke panel and selecting round corner. Then select everything, expand it, and hit D to give it a white fill and a black outline. Bring the loops to the front. Finally, draw in two more shapes like this and your bow is complete. Group everything together and let's place it on the waistband. For the final step, let's draw in our fabric folds and lines and change the variable width profiles for them. Garment number 5 is now done. Garment number 6 is going to be a basic bomber jacket. Let's start with drawing the main shapes on our body form and then move it to the artboard on the right. Hit D, then draw the inner backs of the jacket and color them gray. I'm then drawing a long rectangle at the center front and at the center of which I am going to place the zipper that we created in part 1 along with the zipper head, puller and stopper at the top and bottom which we also made in part 1. I'm then adding two panels on the waistband. And now that my major outlines are done, let's move to the stitch lines. Now my waistband is elasticated, so add in the fold lines that we created before. And for the cuffs at the wrist, add in the ribbed texture that we made in part 1 for the hoodie using the same clip mask technique. Do the same for the neck. Then create the black border and close with creating the fold lines. Garment number 6 is now complete. Our final garment in this series is going to be a basic cardigan. I'm starting with the outlines on my body form, giving it lots of volume so that it looks baggy. Then moving it to my artboard and hitting D. Next, I'm creating a ribbed panel that runs vertically on both sides. For this, I'm simply drawing a line with my pen tool, increasing the stroke and expanding the shape. Also draw in the inner neck band. Next, like I said, I want to give a ribbed texture to these panels. So draw a line that runs through the center like so. Then convert it to the ribbed texture, move it to the side, copy and paste the panel shape over it and clip mask it. Then move it back over the cardigan. Do the same for the right side and the back neck band. Since this is so baggy, let's add in a detail at the sleeves, like so. Next, draw the inner backs of the garment and color them gray. Now I'm adding the rib texture at the hem of the body and the sleeve.
I'm then going to add the black outline. I'm next creating welt pockets, which also have the ribbed texture clip masked on them. And remember the buttons we created for the shirt? Copy paste them onto the cardigan. Our final step, like always, is to create the fold lines and change the variable width profiles for them to either 1 or 4. And finally, our seventh garment is ready.
And that is it, guys. I hope these two videos were useful for you. If you would like me to do a tutorial on more complex shapes, then let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next week.